So as you can see right off the bat, we have new notifications, iPhone 6 Plus, so I do not have like 3D touch or anything, but that's what the notifications look like. Swipe over, you can see your widgets, you can add more, there's a bunch you can add, but that's what the widgets look like. You can show more, if you want to know more, or show less. Swipe over to the right, you have the new camera application, and instead of swiping up. Now to actually unlock your phone, all you have to do is press the home button. I'm not sure how I feel about that, that's kind of weird to me. I just like not having to press the home button, but you actually have to tap it now. That is a little weird. Go back over, you can see notification center still, with all the widgets. If you swipe down, you can see all these notifications that you missed. Probably going to block some of those. You can clear them. Again, do not have 3D touch, but if I did, then... Going to messages. Let's just create a new message. Okay, so messages. You can see I have the camera. And then here's a live feed of my camera right here if I just want to take a picture. Or then you can scroll through other pictures too. Here you can see we have the coloring option. So let me just pick blue and then I can sketch. And let's just say hi. So it's as easy as that. And it automatically sends it. And then here you can go to your Apple Music, stickers, you have these cool retro stickers, kind of cool. And then images, so you can search for an image. So that's pretty cool. Going into maps. You can see the new map app here. Let's just say I want to go to the Holiday Inn, that's cool. Directions. Now you see the different traffic areas, how the red area is heavy traffic and blue is mild. And then you can swipe up and it gives you directions. And it also has a drive, walk, transit, and ride. So that's pretty cool with maps. Photos. Let's go ahead and see the new photo app. You can see here you have shared still. You have memories and it's scanning to make some memories, so that's pretty cool. And then your actual photos. Going into the App Store, because that is actually have been redesigned too. You can see here, this is a new entertainment or a new category layout. So pretty awesome. Now going into settings, you have Siri now, where the Siri icon has been changed. And you have one new wallpaper, which is the one they showed off in the demo. And that's this one right here. So that's pretty much all that's new with settings. Music. You see we have the new redesigned Apple Music app. So that's really awesome. We have my library for you. You can browse music, radio, and search. So that's kind of cool. New HomeKit app, or Home. And then it has my home appliance. I have a smart light bulb, and that's pretty much it. You can add rooms and Apple TV. So that's just a little quick look at the HomeKit app. Going into news. Here's the news redesigned app. And you can see your favorites, explore, search, or saved. So that's pretty cool. Now, something I did discover, and it's really, really cool, is you can actually delete stock apps. Now, there are some that you cannot delete, like your App Store messages, settings, photos, health, which I kind of feel is strange that you can't delete health, wallet. Sadly, you cannot delete the news app. I am really disappointed by that one. Phone, Safari, camera, and find my iPhone, which makes sense. So those are some, and let's just see how this works because I haven't tried this yet. Videos, just say I want to delete that, and boom, it's gone. So that's really, really cool. And that's pretty much a rundown on iOS 10. So if you have spotted anything or you want me to review something more in depth, you can let me know. You can let me know in the comments down below. But that's pretty much iOS 10. I think it's really cool. I think it's a pretty solid update. I love how you can delete stock apps. That's pretty fantastic to me. So thanks for watching and have a good day.